Hi guys, hi YouTubers, hi fellas.
Hi guys, a partner of ours has requested a webinar and further information on the Acronis product family. So to start off, in the small business and large enterprise and the MSP side, they offer a few services, which is Acronis Snap Deploy, where you can create one master image and deploy it across networks, hundreds of thousands of machines, including servers. You can program it so it will automatically image computers once a month, once every 2 weeks. This will be easily done, and it is configured by your Active Directory credentials. This also works with Active Directory as well, and it will automatically join the network, the machine to Active Directory as long as you have NC credentials. Also, the TIP file that Acronis Snap Deploy uses can also be used as an Acronis backup file, so you could recover it if you had a backup, which perfectly fits in with Acronis Cyber Protect, Backup Recovery, and Acronis Home and Office, but the Acronis Home and Office is their consumer product. So the Acronis Cyber Protect, Acronis Backup, and Acronis SaaS platform is where you have your centralized console, and within there you manage all your backups for your laptops, desktops. It will be on one central view. You can even create groups and customize the interface to, like, you can have reports here, backups here, failed jobs here. You can really customize the interface very well, as well as policies. When backups are taken, it checks to see if there is any ransomware, any pups, or any unwanted files. So you could also add exceptions in there. You could back up to network drive, tape, remote shares, Amazon Cloud, Google. The backup jobs are endless. You can run as many as you want, but please note, just make sure that if you're backing up constantly, to make sure there's enough backup space on the dedicated server or the location you're going to. So I'd recommend that you have a retention policy in place. So if you're doing 5 backup jobs, maybe delete the first one so it frees up a bit of space, or create a full backup and then do incrementals after that. Maybe once a day or twice a day if you're at school. Twice a day is more common. First thing in the morning or lunchtime, and 6 o'clock is usually what schools do. So going back to the ASD, the TIP file can be used as an Acronis backup as well as Snap Deploy. So you can really alternate that. You can use the backup file on Acronis Snap Deploy, so you can use that as a mass image to deploy. But please be wary when you do use Acronis Snap Deploy to make sure that you've added the correct drivers in. So personally, it's better to create one master image, but then duplicate the master image and then put like HP image or Dell image, and then it's specifically for that machine for all your drivers in. So that way it's easier to separate, and you know what OS is for what machine or what OS is for what department, like in a school, it could be room 1 image, room 2, IT suite 1, technician image. So going back to Acronis Backup and Acronis Snap Deploy, I'll flip between both. You can create a master password so that when the backup is trying to be recovered or image is trying to be deployed, it needs a password. This can be configured to either be a one-off password, or it could be configured by Active Directory groups so that maybe 3 of the admins and a supervisor, or maybe just a supervisor of access. So that way it is protected the network from unauthorized use, unauthorized deletion, and it's keeping obviously your data safe and secure. You can also virtually mount the drive when you're recovering, as well as when you're recovering, you can put it to a virtual machine, fire it up in the meantime. So you could fire a virtual machine up, that is an exact replica of your network. In the meantime, whilst the server's down, you could be using that virtual machine. And then when the server's back up again, just re-update the backup onto the server so that everything is now being updated and shares and documents, and no staff would lose anything and the staff would be unaware. Or you could send a message across saying, well, there is a server out, but you know what, maybe a bit slower, but other than that, it's still business as always, because at least that way you're having a good RTO and it's still keeping your network up, active, protected. If you need any further information on the Acronis products, you're more than welcome to contact us on our website, which will be in the link below. And I'm also including the latest Acronis Summit of 2022, the Singapore version, because there are different locations of the event. It's that the principle is still the same. I attended virtually, and the other year I actually attended physically, and I honestly can't fault it. It was absolutely a fantastic event to attend as a partner. We got drinks, meals, you got looked after, and it was probably one of the better events that I've gone to. And just to go a bit off topic, but I've recently been invited to a boat party in Malta, because companies now are starting to move back to work, and it's just nice to socialise, but obviously there's still that social distancing and such, but it's nice to, we're kind of being put back to normality, if you will. I am fully aware that I'm just talking about a few of the features that the Acronis products have, but to me these are the most important. So if you need any further information, you're more than welcome to contact us, and I'm more than happy to get an Acronis product specialist on a demo where I would join, as well as the customer, and you could see the Acronis product family in action. Or if you want to just say focus on Acronis backup, we can get that facilitated for you. It will just take a couple of days to get that confirmed, but as soon as that's confirmed, we're more than happy to offer extra services to our existing customers. Or if you're looking to switch backups to Acronis, that'd be fantastic. Acronis has been around now for about 30 years, and they are one of the market leaders in backup, especially in the small business and large enterprise. And I know that they have got a very dominant backup solution when it comes to F1, because I know they were, it's either Toro Rosso or Red Bull, and I think they also do HPE. No, I also think they back up McLaren, but I'm unsure now. I know McLaren have HPE systems, but I'm unsure now. But if anyone needs any demos, further information, please let us know. And as I say, no request is too big or small. And on top of that, when you deploy nodes, so yeah, Acronis products have been around, they've got a trusted customer base, the support is second to none. They can either be contacted on live chat from your support account as long as you have an active warranty, they can be contacted by email or phone, but personally it's better to go into live chat because it's almost instant, or you would get through in a couple of minutes, and then they would connect to the systems by TeamViewer. But when you buy your products from a partner or reseller, we would offer first and second level support, and after that then it would be dealt with by your TAM or a manager, so the case gets expedited and you would get faster support to be resolved. And especially when it comes to schools, Acronis put them as priority number one, because when it comes to impacting education, that is a big no-no for any company. So Acronis have always felt that any request like that will always go to the top. And that has never changed, and year on year that has got stronger. But going back to when I was talking about the nodes, so a node is basically added to a machine, so it shows up in the management console. It's like the agent. And then you can configure the backup jobs on the machine, the policies. It can either be deployed to a group or to all the machines if they're not in the group. But personally, it's better to do it to a group because you could have a group for like servers, a group for laptops, a group for desktops. And usually you have different policies for servers that you would compared to laptops, desktops, or staff machines compared to student machines. So always take into consideration about why you need that policy in place, why would it need to be changed, why would it need to be updated. Don't think a policy has to be important, think of the longevity, think of it being future-proofed in case you may have to change it in the future. Sometimes it's better to put the long work in beforehand, so in the long term you're not having to configure or change different types of policies. Acronis are also offering a new service which is a bit like an RDP, it's a remote connection software, and it is also going to be included moving forward within your subscription monthly or as a one-off payment. I don't know if it's going to be included as a one-off payment one though, as yet, but from what I've heard, yes. Now with the subscription one, you will get cheaper modelling, hence MSP. Also, you've covered a few updates. Same with the resale side where you're buying the license, but for that you're covered up to a year, whereas the MSP side you're constantly covered as long as you're paying for the product. Every product has its advantages and disadvantages. Now, personally, I only add companies that I see intrinsic value to customers and to I as a partner to a business, and I work with Acronis now for just under 6 years. And every year we work with them, we've gone from strength to strength. It's opened more doors, a lot more customers have come to us because we've recognised Acronis as a trusted, a well-known brand. I have no doubt that Acronis, yet again, are going to be the market leader moving forward. As mentioned before, we are adding on to CyberSumit 2022 at the end of the video. It is about 2 hours long, but there are points where you can skip to if you're looking for a key point. If you'd like further information or to have a demo arranged, please contact us in the link below. And I or on the team, we're more than happy to get back to you and assist you further with your request. Thank you for watching and bye bye.
If you need to contact us for further information, you can reach us on the website that's going to be in the description. You can also contact us on our live chat service. You can contact us on the YouTube comments, we'd be more than happy to assist you. You can reach us at acs@cyberservices.com. And the contact numbers are +44 for international dial, and that would be 1704 893 447. You can also reach me on my mobile at 07494 027783. If you need to contact us on any further information about our webinars or demos, please let us know, and I and one of the team would be very happy to assist you. Thank you. But please note that when you are coming to us with regard to an educational request, please also send in some form of identification, or if you are a member of staff, say the IT administrator, please send in a letter from the head teacher with a manual signature so that we can apply an educational discount. But please be aware that you may have to buy so many licenses in order to get a discount. Thank you and bye bye.